Insects are only invertebrates that can fly. Their wings are developed as evagination of the exoskeleton during morphogenesis, but they become fully functional only during the adult stage of an insect's life cycle. The wings may be membranous, parchment-like, evenly sclerotized, fringed with long ears or covered with scales. Most of the insects have two pairs of wings, one pair on the mesothorax and one pair on the metathorax. Wings serve not only as organs of flight, but also may be adapted variously as protective covers in Coleoptera and Dermoptera, thermal collectors and sexual contact in Lepidoptera, gyroscopic stabilizer in Diptera, sound producer in Orthoptera. In arthropods, antennae are connected to the frontmost segment. In crustaceans, biramous antennae are present on the first two segments of the head with the smaller pair known as antennules. All other arthropod groups except Therizinids are and Protonews which have uniramous pair of antennae. These antennae are jointed at the base and in general extend forward from the head. They are sensory organs, although the exact nature of what they sense and how they sense it is not the same in all groups are always clear. Functions may variously include sensing touch, air motion, heat, vibration and especially olfaction or gustation. Antennae are the primary olfactory sensor of insects. Paired, mobile and segmented, they are located between the eyes and the forehead. All insects have antenna, however, they may be greatly reduced in the larval forms. Among the non-insect classes of the exopoda, both Colembola and Diptera have antennae, but Protura do not have antennae. Objectives. Number 1. To distinguish insects from other small creatures. Number 2. To learn the external morphology of insects. Number 3. To study specializations and adaptability of structures such as the mouth parts, antennae, legs, wings and protonem. Number 4. To understand how an insect lives, functions and reproduces. Number 5. To discover that insects are in our field and whether they are beneficial or non-beneficial. Number 6. Entomologists will able to name several supplementary body parts of an insect. Number 7. To consider various ways to deal with pest and attack beneficial. Number 8. Identify the characteristic of insects. Number 9. Identify structural adaptations that insects have for surviving in marsh conditions. Number 10. To understand the taxonomic system used for classifying insects. Adult Lepidoptera have two pairs of membranous wings covered usually completely by minute scales. A wing consists of an upper and lower membrane which are connected by a minute fibers and strengthened by a system of thickened alar ribs, popularly but incorrectly referred as veins, as they may also contain trachea, nerve fibers and blood vessels. The membranes are covered with minute scales which have jagged ends or ears and are attached by hooks. The wings are moved by the rapid muscular contraction and expansion of the thorax. The wings arise from the meso and metathoracic segments and are similar in size in the basal groups. In more derived groups, the mesothoracic wings are larger with more powerful musculature at their bases and more rapid vein structure on the costal hedge. Types of wings. The wings are covered with scales forming the extraordinary variety seen in color. The mesothorax is designed to have a more powerful muscle to propel moth or butterfly through the hair, with the wing segment having a stronger wing structure. The larger superfamily Nactidae has the wings modified to act as a tympanal or hearing organs. Structures. Each wing consists of a thin membrane supported by a system of veins. The membrane is formed by two layers of integument closed opposite, while the veins are formed where the two layers remain separate and the lower cuticle may be thicker and more heavily sclerotized. Within each of the major veins there is a nerve and trachea, and since the cavities of the veins are connected with the emolymph can flow into the wings. The remaining area form channels, the future veins in which the nerves and trachea may occur. The cuticle surrounding the veins becomes thicker and more heavily sclerotized to provide strength and rigidity to the wing. Two types of hairs may occur on the wings: microtrichia, which are small and irregularly scattered, and macrotrichia, which are larger, socketed, and may be restricted to veins. The scales of Lepidoptera and Trichoptera are highly modified macrotrichia. Shape. The shape of the wings exhibit great variety in Lepidoptera. In the case of the Papilionidae, the costa may be straight or highly arched. It is sometimes concave on the hind wing. It is occasionally serrate or minutely saw-toothed on the forewing. The apex may be rounded, pointed, or faceted. The sternum tends to be straight or concave on the forewing, while it is usually more or less convex on the hind wing. The sternum is often crenulate or dented. It is produced at each vein and concave in between them. The dorsum is normally straight but may be concave. The hind wing is frequently chordate, that is, the veins near the end of the tarsus have one or more ties. The tarsus itself being often produced and frequently lobed. Along the hind wing sternum, there are tightly packed scales in a double row. The underside of the scales project and they form a regular narrow frid referred as cilia. Venation. In most of the cases, a characteristic network of veins runs throughout the wings tissues. These veins are extension of the body circulatory system. They are filled with emolymph and contain a tracheal tube and a nerve. In membranous wings, the veins provide strength and reinforcement during flight. Wing shape, texture, and venation are quite distinctive among the insect taxa and therefore highly useful as aids for identification. Lepidoptera venation is simple in that there are few crossbars. The wing venation in Lepidoptera is a diagnostic for distinguishing between the taxa as also the genera and families. The terminology is based on the Comstock-Needham system, which gives the morphological description of insect wing venation. In the basal Lepidoptera, the venation of the forewing is similar to that of the hind wing, a condition referred to as homoneurous. The Micropterygii have venation that resembles that most primitive caddis fish. All other Lepidoptera, the vast majority, are heteroneurous, the venation of the hind wing differing from that of the forewing and being sometimes reduced. Modification in the wings venation include several types, namely costa, it is found only in butterfly. Number 2, subcosta, it is the leading wing marginal, fused or very close for most of the length in hind wing, fused and well developed in the humeral area. Subcosta never branches in butterfly. Number 3, radius, it divides into branches behind the middle of the wing, up to 5 branches in Papilionidae. Number 4, radius sector, it is present in hind wing. Number 5, media, the basal section has been lost. Number 6, cubitus anterior, cup section has been lost. Number 7, anal veins, either one vein A or two veins, 1A plus 2A, 3A. Number 8, humeral vein, the hind wing of most butterfly as the humeral vein except Lacinidae. The wings, head, parts of the thorax and abdomen of Lepidoptera are covered with minute scales, which gives the names to this order. The name Lepidoptera was coined in 1735 by Carl Linnaeus for the group of insects with four scaly wings. It is derived from ancient Greek lepidos, a scale itself originating from the Greek lepis meaning scale and apteron or wing. Most scales are lamellar, or blade-like and attached with a pedicel. With other forms may be ear-like or specialized as secondary sexual characteristics. The lumen or surface of the lamella as a complex structure. Scales cover the head, parts of the thorax and abdomen as well as parts of the genitalia. The morphology of scales has been studied by Downey and Allen, and scales have been classified into three groups, namely ear-like, blade-like and other variable forms. It gives color either due to the pigmentary colors contained with or due to its three-dimensional structure. Structure of scales. A few taxa of the Trichoptera, which are the sister group of Lepidoptera, having a ear-like scales but always on the wings and never on the body or other parts of the insect. Caddis flies also possess a caudal circe on the abdomen. This feature absent in the Lepidoptera. According to Scob, morphologically scales are microtrichia and thus homologous with the large ears that cover the wings of the Trichoptera. Although there is a great diversity in scale form, they are all share a similar structure. Scales like other microtrichids arise from special trichogenic cells and have a socket which is enclosed in a special termogen cell. This arrangement provides a stalk or pedicel by which scales are attached to the substrate. Scales may be piliform or flattened. The body or blade are a typical flattened scale consist of an upper and lower lamella with an ear space in between them. The surface towards the body is smooth and known as inferior lamella. The upper surface or superior lamella has transverse and longitudinal ridges and ribs. The lamella are held apart by struts called tubercule and contain pigments which give color. The scales cling somewhat loosely to the wing and come off easily without arming the butterfly. Color of the scale. Scales on the insect wings are pigmented with melanins that can produce black and brown. The white color in the butterfly family, Peridae, is a derivative of uric acid and excretory product. Bright blue, green, red and iridescence are usually created not by pigments but through the microstructure of the scales. This structural coloration is the result of coherent scattering of the light by photonic crystal. Nature of the scales. The specialized scales that provide structural colors to reflected light mostly produce ultraviolet patterns which are discernible in that part of the ultraviolet spectrum that Lepidopteran eyes can see. The structural colors seen in often depended upon the angle of view. For example, in marsupials, the color from the front is bright blue, but when seen from an angle, they vary quickly to black. The iridescent structural coloration seen in the wings of the many papilionata species. In the case of the Trichoplas erypelis, the three-dimensional photonic structure has been examined by transmission electron topography and computer modeling to reveal naturally occurring chiral tetrahedral repeating units packed in a triclinic lattice, the cause of iridescence. Scales may have evolved initially for providing insulation. Scales on the thorax and other parts of the body may contribute to maintaining the high body temperature required during flight. The solid scales of the basal mass are, however, not as efficient as those of their more advanced relatives as the presence of a lumen or air layers and increases the insulation value. Functions. In insects with relatively light bodies and large wings, the wing muscles in the thorax fall directly on the wing where it is articulated to the thorax, leaving it up and down. Insects such as bees, wasps and flies with compact bodies and a smaller wing area have indirect muscles which elevate and depress muscles which elevate and depress the wings very rapidly by pulling on the walls of the thorax and changing its shape. In both cases, there are flight muscles which acting on the wing insertion can alter its angle in the hair. During the downstroke, the wing is held horizontally, so thrusting downwards on the hair and producing a lifting force. During the upstroke, the wing is rotated vertically and offer little resistance during its upward movement through the hair. Besides providing the primary functions of the flight, wing also have secondary functions of self-defense, camouflage and thermoregulation. In some lepidopteran families such as the cycadae and lamantidae, the wings are reduced or even absent. Scales provide a number of functions which include insulation, thermoregulation, hiding gliding flight, among others, the most important of which is the large diversity of vivid or indistinct patterns they provide, which help the organism protect itself by camouflage, mimicry and warming, providing insulation and involved in thermoregulation. The main sense organs of most insects are the antenna and their head. These often long and slender projections are covered with tiny sensitive hairs. As well as the feeling, the antennae are also used for smelling and sometimes for taste and hearing. Antennae are feelers, giant sense organs located on the heads of the centipedes, millipedes, crustaceans, silk moth and certain insects. Crustaceans typically have two pairs of antennae, insects have only one pair of antennae. Insect antennae are vary in length and shape from species to species and sometimes according to sex. The antennae of some insects are longer than the body, those of others are shorter distance. Insect antennae may be thread-like, beaded-like, elbowed, saw-toothed, feathery or club-shaped. Types of antennae. Number 1. Aristate antennae. These antennae are pouch-like with a lateral distal, example housefly. Number 2. Capitate antennae. These antennae are abruptly clubbed at the hand, example butterfly. Number 3. Clavate antennae. These antennae are gradually clubbed at the hand, example carrion beetle. Number 4. Filiformis antennae. Filiformis antennae are thread-like shape, example ground beetles and cockroaches. Number 5. Geniculate antennae. Geniculate antennae are hinged or bent like an elbow, example bees and ants. Number 6. Muniform antennae. Muniform antennae are beaded like in shape, example termites. Number 7. Pectinate antennae. Pectinate antennae are comb like shape, example fiery colored beetles and grow worms. Number 8. Plumose antennae. Plumose antennae are brush like or feather like shape, example silk moths and mosquitoes. Number 9. Serrate antennae. Serrate antennae are saw-toothed shape, example click beetles. Number 10. Cetaceous antennae. Cetaceous antennae are distal like shape, example dragonfly. Structure. The three basic segments of the typical insect antennae are the scape, the pedicel and finally the flagellum, which often comprises many units known as flagellomers. The pedicel contains the Johnston organ, which is collection of sensory cells. The number of flagellomers can vary greatly and is often of the diagnostic importance. True flagellomers have a membranous articulation between them, but in many insects, especially the more primitive groups, the flagellum is entirely or partially composed of a flexible series of small annuli, which are not true flagellomers. In many beetles and in the chalcicard wasps, the apical flagellomers form a club, and the collective term for the segments between the club and the antennal base in the pedicel. For traditional reasons, in beetles it is the segments between the club and the scape, but in wasps it is the segments between the club and the pedicel. In the groups with more uniform antennae, all segments are called annulomers. Some groups have a simple or variously modified apical or sub-apical vistula called an arista. Functions. Antennae serve many functions. In most insects, they are organs of touch, taste, smell and hearing. In some water beetles, they act as respiratory organs. In certain crustaceans, they are used for locomotion. In many soil insects, antennae serve as organs of communication. Olfactory receptors on the antennae bind to free floating molecules such as water vapor and odors including pheromones. The neurons that possess these receptors signal this binding by sending action potential down their axon to the antennal lobe in the brain. From these, neurons in the antennal lobes contact to mushroom bodies that identify the color. The sum of the electrical potential of the antennae to given odor can be measured using an electroantennogram. In the case of the monarch butterfly, it has been shown that antennae are necessary for proper time compensated solar compass orientation during migration, that antennal clocks exist in monarchs and that they are likely to provide the primary timing mechanism for the some compass orientation. Leg movements in insects are controlled by largely independent local neural circuits that are connected to their neighbors. There is no central controller that coordinates the leg during walking. The leg coordination comes about by the exploitation of the interaction with the environment. If the insect stands on the ground and moves forward by pushing backward with one of its legs, as an unavoidable implication of the being embodied, all the joint angles of the leg standing on the ground will instantaneously change. The insect's body is pushed forward and consequently the other legs are also pulled forward and the joint will be bent or stretched. This fact can be exploited to the animal's advantage. All that is needed is angle sensor in the joints and they to exist for measuring the change, and there is a global communication between the legs. But the communication is through the interaction of the agent with the environment, not through neural processing. Inspired by the fact that the local neural leg controls need only exploit this global communication, a neural network architecture called WalkNet has been developed, which is capable of controlling a six-legged robot. This instance of morphological computation take over part of the task that would have to be done by brain, the communication between the legs and the calculation of the angles of the all joints are performed by the interaction between the insect and the world. Walking. An adult insect uses six legs for walking and adopted a tripedal gait. The tripedal gait allows for rapid walking while always having a stable stance and has been studied extensively in insects. The legs are used in alternate triangles touching the ground. For the first step, the middle right leg and the front and the rear left legs are in a contact with the ground and move the insect forward, while the front and rear right leg and the middle left leg are lifted and moved forward to a new position. When they touch the ground to form a new stable triangle, the other legs can be lifted and brought forward in turn and so on. The purest form of the tripedal gait is seen in insects moving in at high speeds. However, this type of locomotion is not rigid and insects can adopt a variety of gaits. Cockroaches are among the fastest insects runners and at full speed adopt a bipedal run to reach a high velocity in proportion to their body size. As cockroaches move very quickly, they need to be video recorded at 700 frames per second to several their gaits. More sedate locomotion is seen in the stick insects or walking insects. A few insects have evolved to walk on the surface of the water, especially the bugs of the Gyridae family, commonly known as water striders. A few species of ocean skaters in the genus halobates even live on the surface of the open oceans, a habitat that are few insect species.